today I will continue explaining the Gambit database. Last lecture I gave on databases, we were able to write a code for three categories. First one, get single answer from a database. Second category, get many rows, many columns from database. Third category, insert, update, delete. Fourth category, the time was over, so today I will go through the fourth category. However, I put all the code you need and the instruction in the BBT file that Professor Mahmoud posted on the C# website, as well as I created PDF file to show you how to go through all steps on database server to create a stop procedure, and then the code is provided also how to call that. So I will give review a little bit for 5 minutes for what we did last lecture to be able to continue, okay? So we created a class. And in this class, the DB function, and in this class, we specify the connection string. And as I mentioned, connection string is like the address to show the connection address later on where to go, what's the machine name, what's the authentication, what is the authentication information like username and password, and what's the database name, because the server might have multiple databases. So here we said that for password and username, we are using integrated security equal to, and this is like a shortcut for using username and password that are created on your laptop. This is if the server on your laptop. Let me ask you a question. If you try to remotely access database which is not resides on your laptop, would you be able to use this technique?
No.
So in that case, you need to create username and password, and I will show you next section when we write the code how to do that. This is easier way to work on this on your laptop. So first, so first function we created was getScalar, and this method takes string, SQL string, and return an object. And we are using this approach when we need to get single answer from the database. So we first create the connection object, and we tied it to a connection string. And in try, catch, finally block, we write our code in try. We open the connection, we create command object, and we call execute scalar method, and we return object. This is for the first approach. Second approach, which we need to retrieve many rows and many columns. For the second approach, we create a function, get data table. It takes string SQL and it brings data table. And as we mentioned, it's a good approach to create a blank data table. And it's the same, as we mentioned, it's the same steps, except here we are creating data adapter. However, in the first method, we were creating command object. So data adapter is the object which retrieves many rows, many columns, because command object is only able to retrieve one piece of information. However, data adapter can retrieve many rows and many columns. And we said depends on the on the server, database server you are using, and this prefix can be changed. It can be Oracle, data adapter, it can be data adapter. And we have to pass it to a piece of information, SQL and connection, the connection object. By passing these two information, the data adapter will have all the information it needs. That's SQL, what we need to create. Maybe I need to retrieve the name from students. I need to retrieve course name and course number from courses. So what I need to retrieve from my database, also what's the connection string, which already have the address, the server name, username, password, and database. And we also said you always, and finally we close the connection. Even we close the connection, we have the data table in the memory of our computer, because we use fill method, and fill method, once this line of code is gets executed, the data table, so data adapter will go to the database, bring all the information we need, and dump this database in our memory. And then once I close the connection, I don't need it. Maybe there's a lot of users are using multiple copies of our database, so we don't need to run out of connections, so we need to close it. And then I have the data table, and then I can display it, I can retrieve whatever information I need. And to demonstrate this, as you may remember, I create combo box, and once the form started, it populates the IDs in the product table. So I create product table which has three items with these with the different IDs, and it has product ID column, it has product name, it has price, and it has description. So once I click, once I choose or I pick any ID, it will give me all the information related to this ID. So this, I have the ID, this product name, bicycle, the price, and the description. If I go and pick another ID, it will give me the other option, which is calculator, and 1, 2, 3, 6, it will give me the third option, which is laptop. And to go over the code for that, we did two things. First, in the form itself, in order to populate the combo box with BDIs for product table, I had to call, to write the SQL, and then I had to pass the SQL to BT, because I need to bring all the columns. I need to bring the product ID, the description, and the price, and the product name. So I have to use which approach? Get data table function, where we create data adapter, and we call fill method. And we always said that we, for this function, it takes SQL and it returns data table. And we loop through all the rows and all the columns in that table. So here, combo box has collection called items, and always when you see us, that's indicator for this is collections. So all this collection ends with us letter. So we cannot add directly to combo box. However, we can add through to the items. And also it uses indexer, you know, here, indexer, to search and populate, to search and bring the ID, and then it gets up populated once the form starts. So this code has to be done in for load event, okay? Like sometimes I in the exam you might get like what code you need to write in for load, or how we can get how we can populate the product ID in the form, and then you need to mention that this code has to go in form load. Now, any code we need to write in combo box, where when we pick the product ID, we will get all the
information,
the information or the details related to that particular ID. This has to go in selected gets changed event. So, last lecture, if you go through the lecture, you will see how I highlight the combo and go to events and make that event, and then write this code here. So simply, this is our selected ID from the combo box, and here we need to bring all the data related to that particular ID, and we give it to we invoke get data function, and now we have it in our memory in the data table. And here how I go through how we go through all the column. So I, as I said, rows also is the collections, and here is the column name. And when, and this is indexer, as you know. And then in the indexer, we can, we don't go by the number, we go always by the name of the column, okay? This to be able to understand this part of code. Also, there is a very powerful tool we can use to display all the values that we have in our data table. And this called grid view. And how I get this one, I go to toolbox, I go to data, and from data I can make data grid view, okay? So I can get that, and here we can give it a name. I only need to get a name, and then I will use it to display all the column from my database. So because I already got one, so I did this, and we can see here, instead of writing this code, we can do easier way. It depends like what, how you would like to display your the details.